Winning the environmental war will require a commitment far beyond any commitment ever made by any society in the history of man. Are we able? Yes. Are we willing? That's the unanswered question.
Today, we are faced with a challenge that calls for a shift in our thinking so that humanity stops threatening its life support system.
The oceans are being assaulted by carbon dioxide, plastic and pollution, illegal fishing and too much fishing in some places. It's huge and it's powerful and it's big, but it's fragile.
Together, citizens of the world, we will work to save our planet from ourselves.
There is a place in Baja California called Cabo Pulmo. 30 years ago, its fish populations were completely decimated. And then one brave family decided to prohibit fishing on their own reef. In a single human generation, the fish have come back spectacularly. The ocean has an extraordinary capacity to regenerate when it is protected.
We're not going to meet this challenge unless the community of nations comes together around a single, comprehensive, global ocean strategy.
Tal vez una de las más difíciles decisiones que tiene un líder es cómo equilibra las necesidades de la economía con las necesidades del medio ambiente.
Today I can announce we are taking steps to create two new marine sanctuaries.
The New Zealand government will establish a 620,000 square kilometre ocean sanctuary in the Kermadec region.
Kiribati has taken the decision to fully close all commercial fishing activities within the Phoenix Islands protected area.
Pour augmenter la résilience de l'océan, il faudrait lutter contre le réchauffement climatique. Monter en puissance sur les énergies renouvelables, y compris les énergies renouvelables marines.
Norway will do its part to combat marine plastic waste and microplastics.
Con voluntad política, con iniciativa de los gobiernos, esto se puede hacer. No es imposible.
Threats facing the ocean. There's nothing that we're looking at that doesn't have a solution.